Greenville, I'm Lainey.
And I'm Sophie, and we are reporting live from Channel 3 WCCES News on the campus of Christ Church Episcopal School, home of the Cavaliers.
We have an entire hour of news tonight full of history, great options for the weekend ahead, and we even have an exciting twist for you. Stay tuned.
Yes, Lainey, we are here tonight to highlight some of the features of the great state, South Carolina, nicknamed the Palmetto State.
We want to share with you a few things that makes our state special.
South Carolina is a great place to visit, but an even better place to live.
Hello, I'm Preston. First, before I begin, we need to educate you on the basics. A little geography on this southern state we call home. For instance, did you know our state is shaped like a triangle, with North Carolina on one side, Georgia on the other, and the Atlantic Ocean on the third side? Now let's hear from Owen, who will give us more information.
I love the mountains that are on the northern border of the state. Did you know that they're called the Blue Ridge Mountains because of their hazy blue appearance on the horizon? Speaking of the mountains, one of our greatest resources is the water that flows all the way down from the mountains through the state's river systems and straight to the Atlantic Ocean.
Did you know that South Carolina's coast is one of the most scenic in the United States? We have more than 60 miles of beautiful beaches known as the Grand Strand. There are more than 70 golf courses, historical sites, fishing boats, and yummy seafood. What a great way to soak up some sun for a weekend or a long vacation. I'm Andrew, reporting for Channel 3.
There are also 6 different regions around the state.
Cool! Let's hear about our state's regions and resources before our news program begins. Now let's listen as the third grade teaches us more about South Carolina's regions and resources.
A great way to learn about the geography of South Carolina. Now let's head down to Columbia, our state capital, where Eliana is meeting with Governor McMaster, our 117th governor of the state, and our lieutenant governor, Pamela Avett.
I'm live from the State House in Columbia. Governor McMaster and Lieutenant Governor Pamela Vett have joined us to explain some of the history of our state's government. Thanks for joining us, Governor McMaster and Lieutenant Governor Vett. Can you tell us a bit about our state's government?
I would be delighted to start. South Carolina has had three state houses in the past 200 years. The capital was moved from Charleston to Columbia in 1789. The current state house began construction in the early 1850s. Several delays, including the Civil War, prevented completion until 1904. Our capital's historic halls include the Senate, House of Representatives, Governor and Lieutenant Governor's offices. The elected officials who preside in the House of Representatives help to make laws to keep all of South Carolinians safe.
I'm proud to say I'm the first female Republican Lieutenant Governor of state's history. I am second command to the governor. My main duty is to act as governor should the governor be temporarily absent from his office. I also handle most ceremony events in our state.
Thank you, Governor McMaster and Lieutenant Governor Vett. Now let's head over to our state's museum so we can learn more about South Carolina's history.
I'm Miguel reporting live from the State Museum. The South Carolina State Museum is a state of art attraction featuring four floors and permanent and changing exhibits. Let's meet our tour guide, Yate, for this history lesson in the Historical Wax Museum.
Hi, welcome. I'm happy to have you here today. We are now going to learn about the history of the state flag, some early heroes and heroines of South Carolina.
Sergeant Jasper, Colonel Moultrie, sir. Sergeant Jasper, I've always wanted to tell you how proud I was that first day we fought the British off the coast of Charleston.
Sir, I was only doing my duty, sir.
Perhaps, Sergeant, but you went beyond your duties when you bounded over the fort wall to save our flag. That courageous act rallied our troops and turned the battle in our favor.
I was glad to be of service, sir. And might I be bold enough to say, sir, that it was brilliant of you to use Palmetto trees to build a fort. Without them, we would have been doomed. It was amazing how those cannonballs just sank right in the logs.
Why, thank you, Sergeant. Good day.
Good day, sir.
Oh, my. I didn't expect to see you all here. I guess I should introduce myself since I don't seem to have a proper calling card. I'm Eliza Lucas Pickney, girl genius, if I do say so myself. I ran a plantation when I was just a teenager. My experience with indigo made this cash crop a huge success. For my work, Charleston shipped out 5,000 pounds of indigo a year. After my work, 130,000 were exported.
My name is Thomas Sumter, better known as Gamecock. I had my share of trouble in war. Remember that time I carelessly let my men go swimming in a creek after I'd captured British supplies? Only to be caught later, but by the very troops we had shipped. Colonel Pickens, you proved yourself to be a wise leader.
Since I am known as the Wizard Owl, I'm glad there's some truth there. Winning the Battle of Cappens, not too far from Hero's Pillars, was his victory, even though I'd rather fight in the mountains than in the low country swamps.
We Revolutionary War heroes sure stirred up some trouble with the British back in our day. I was a general in the American Revolution and was appointed to this most distinguished position near my dear friend, General George Washington. One of my most notable defeats against Cornwallis is when I pushed his men back from Yorktown in the Revolutionary War battle. That's the truth, or I am not General Nathanael Greene.
Excuse us, but you men weren't the only ones to help win the war with England.
Absolutely not. We went ahead and handed the victory, too.
My name is Emily Yeager, and I not only spied for the Patriots, but I got caught.
I was lucky and never got caught. My name is Kate Moore Berry. I was older than you, but guess what I had to do? There was no one in my home when I had to deliver an important secret message to General Greene. I had to leave my baby alone, so I used a sheet to tie my baby to the bedpost to keep him safe.
Did you get the message to our troops?
I sure did, and my baby was sleeping tight when I got back home.
That's amazing. Listen to this. When I was caught by the British, I ate the paper message. When they weren't looking, of course. So they couldn't read it.
What happened after that?
They had to let me go when they couldn't find anything. Then I moseyed on my way and delivered the message.
Our sacrifices and spy adventures helped the colonies become a united nation.
The first South Carolinians were here long before the settlers arrived in Europe and Africa. Let's see a piece of their story.
We are here to one of the tribes who lived in South Carolina. Some of the tribes of this region were Catawba, Chicora, Piti, Santee, and Cherokee. The Cusaba and the Natchez joined, and later they took the name Edisto.
Tribes lived all what we now call South Carolina. The Cherokee were a tribe within the upstate. Coastal tribes built longhouses made of mud and branches. They grew corn, squash, and beans. And they fished from the islands.
Sadly, the population of many tribes declined because of many diseases brought by the settlers or the conflicts over land ownership.
Music, dance, and story are part of the sacred rituals of Native people. They passed on songs over generations, but much of the music was lost.
That wraps up our history lesson from the State Museum in Columbia. Thank you for joining us.
We're taking over the show. Yo.
Can you believe they left us out of the museum exhibit? We can pose with the best of them.
I guess that's why. My name is Steed Bonnet, and I'm known as the Gentleman Pirate. This here is my fierce friend Blackbeard, and this be Anne Bonny, a most dangerous lass. Don't get on our bad side if you get my meaning.
Arr, me mateys, where might we be?
Shiver me timbers, Captain Blackbeard. We be marooned among these fine landlubbers.
Aye, you scurvy dogs. We be lucky we aren't in Davy Jones' locker. Mary Read and I fought like men when our ship was broadsided, and we lived, at least for a while, to talk about it. You all weren't so lucky.
Yarr!
Anne Bonny and I teamed up, but we were considered to be bad luck on ships. We proved them wrong. She's treasured in coins for her own likings.
Yarr!
Yarr!
Yes, we're the robbers of the sea, also known to ye landlubbers as pirates.
If we may train come to a halt, it be jewels, diamonds, gold we are after.
Yarr!
Yarr!
All right, mateys, let's go find some treasure elsewhere.
Yarr!
Wow, that was a pretty cool way to learn about some of our state history. Not far from the State Museum, you can find America's best zoos. So let's pop over there and hear more about it.
Welcome to the Riverbank Zoo and Garden. I'm your guide, Liam. We are home to more than 2,000 animals, and we have one of the nation's most beautiful botanical gardens. The zoo opened in 1974. Our most popular exhibits are the aquarium, the sea lion show, and the koala house. You can pet farm animals or feed the giraffes that come right up to the exhibit fence. Watch out for their 20-inch black tongues. Did you know that no two giraffes have the same spot pattern? You can spend a whole day at our zoo and still not see it all.
Speaking of great things to see in our state, I'm Emma Sippy. I will be taking you 18 miles south of Columbia to a well-hidden secret of our state. Sims will help us learn about the state gem.
Welcome to Congaree National Park, often referred to as Congaree Swamp. I'm your guide, Sips Collins. The park preserves the largest tract of the hardwood trees in the United States. They grow in floodplain forests and are some of the tallest trees in the eastern United States. There are cypress trees that were 500 years old. Visitors walk on the boardwalk that is 2.4 miles through the swampy forest. If you look up, the sun is hidden by the tall trees. You won't need sunscreen, but be sure to bring lots of bug spray. Waters from Congaree and Watery River sweep through the floodplain, carrying nutrients that rejuvenate the ecosystem and support the growth of these huge trees. It's an incredible place to visit.
Got him, darn mosquito.
Now join us live in the Low Country as we check in with the fine folks from Myrtle Beach. Clay, how's it going down there?
It's going great. I'm coming to you live from Broadway at the Beach. Each year, Broadway at the Beach stands alone as the gem of the Grand Strand's most popular tourist destination. We are lucky tonight to have with us South Carolina's very own Vanna White. Let's welcome Vanna to the stage.
Thank you for having me. I'm co-host of America's favorite game show, Wheel of Fortune, and I'm proud from Conway. I've been turning letters with Pat Sajak since 1982. I am pleased to be here tonight, so let's G-O! Didn't recognize me. I'm a peach. Did you know that South Carolina grows 60,000 tons of peaches a year? We lead all southern states in peach production, including Georgia, and they call themselves the Peach State. After California, South Carolina is the second leading producer of peaches in the United States. I became the official state fruit in 1984.
Body good is how the saying goes. Around 90 state dairies make sure that it still flows. Milk became the state beverage in 1984. You'll have a white mustache if you drink more and more.
Let's go! Party rock is in the house tonight. Everybody just have a good time. And we gon' make you look.
Yellow, yellow, flowers of gold, blooming in the early spring after the cold. No flower that blooms has such a sweet fragrance. I'm so pretty, I've been told. I'm the state flower, yellow jasmine.
Thank you.
a long, dark body with rows of yellow spots. As you stay amphibian, I am sure like the lot. I am the spotted salamander. I became the stay amphibian in 1999. I'm hard to find, even though there are a lot of me in South Carolina.
Pack it up, pack it in. Let me begin. I can't know when that'll mean that's a sin. I won't ever slack up. Pack it, better back up. Try and play the role and you're the whole football act up. Get up, stand up. Come on, throw your hands up if you got the feeling. Jump up past the ceiling. Watch with the fake club. Someone's fucking jump. Yo, I'll bust him in the eye.
Boykin Spaniel. I became the state dog in 1985. I was originally bred by South Carolina hunters to hunt ducks and wild turkeys. I'm a friendly, social dog that is considered a good family pet.
Who let the dogs out?
Designated the loggerhead turtle as the state reptile in 1988. I'm an ancient and mysterious animal that can weigh up to 200 pounds. I build my nest on the coastal beaches of our state. I can live to 150 eggs.
About our state fish, the striped bass. The striped bass was the striped bass is aggressive in nature and large in size. It can weigh up to 30 to 40 pounds. The striped bass is found in South Carolina lakes and reservoirs. It became our state fish in 1972. Most people call it by its nickname, a striple.
Thank you.
Did you know South Carolina designated the white-tailed deer as its official state animal in 1972? The white-tailed deer is known for its incredible beauty and power. It can weigh up to 400 pounds and run up to 40 miles an hour. The white-tailed deer can be found throughout our great state.
That can be hard to see, but boy, can I layer an amazing number of decibels. That's tweets for my size. I replaced the mockingbird of South Carolina State Bird in 1948. And the winner is Carolina Wren. Thanks for joining us tonight. Take a quick 60-second commercial break to applaud one of the state's biggest assets, BMW.
Wir sind das BMW-Werk in der Region Spartanburg. Wir haben gerade angefangen mit dem Bau eines ganz neuen Trainingszentrums. Die mehr als 6000 Quadratmeter große Anlage produziert mehr als 1500 Fahrzeuge am Tag. Wir sind das größte Werk der BMW-Gruppe.
Allow me to translate. We are at the BMW Manufacturing Campus located in Spartanburg County. We have recently broken ground on the new state-of-the-art training center. The 67,000 square foot facility produces more than 1,500 vehicles each day. We are the largest BMW group plant in the world.
Welcome back. Now let's join the game day crew on the campus of Clemson University.
Welcome to game day, folks. My name is Ford, and this is Lila, and we are live in beautiful Clemson, South Carolina, home of the 1981, 2016, and 2018 football national champions. It is a beautiful Thursday night here in Tigertown. Clemson opens their season against Georgia Tech tonight.
Not only is South Carolina home to the Clemson Tigers, but it is home to many other great colleges and universities, too. I have seen fans here tonight from the University of South Carolina, Furman, the Citadel, and Wofford.
Wow, look at all these fans opening day. Hey, Lila, let's get some fans up on set to chat with us for a bit. I see a Furman Paladin out in the crowd.
I see you're here for the season opener. Tell us a little about your school.
We are the number one liberal arts school in our state, and we are located in Greenville. Our colors are purple and white. We kick off our season this Saturday against North Greenville University in our home turf. We thought we'd check out the Tigers' first game. Go Paladins!
Look, there's the coach of the 2022 NCAA Women's Basketball National Champions.
Thanks for having me. I've been the head coach at USC since 2007. While coaching the Lady Gamecocks, we've won 5 SEC regular season championships, 5 SEC tournament championships, 7 Sweet 16s, 3 Final Fours, and on March 13th, 2022, we won our second NCAA Women's Basketball National Championships. Spurs up!
I also see a Wofford Terrier on set. Let's see what Brandon has to say.
Our season's open Saturday in Chattanooga against the Chattanooga Moccasins. Speaking of Terriers, we have one of our most famous alumni here with us today. You may recognize him from the Today Show. Please welcome Mr. Craig Melvin!
Thank you, Brandon. It's a great pleasure to join you this evening. I was born in Columbia, South Carolina, and graduated from Wofford in 2001. I've been reporting news from the last 21 years, beginning at WIST-TV in Columbia, to my current seat on the set of the Today Show. You know, I really enjoyed my time at Wofford. One of our biggest rivals was the Citadel Bulldogs. Why don't we hear from a Citadel fan?
Good evening. Thanks for having me. The Citadel is home to the Fighting Bulldogs. We kick off our season against Campbell University on September 3rd. Go Bulldogs!
On behalf of the Compton community, we would like to thank you for visiting Tigertown. We would look forward to visiting to Columbia in November to play in the Palmetto Bowl, our state rival game. We've been battling since 1960. Go Tigers!
Whoa, is that great or what? We have a celebrity guest picker joining us. Please welcome Hunter Renfrow.
Of course I'm picking the Tigers tonight because they picked me as their preferred walk-on. You might remember the night where Deshaun Watson threw me a pass to clinch the win in the 2016 National Championship. I'm all in all the time.
Incredible. We're taking you live to Greenville, South Carolina, to Greenville C4A 2022. Here you will find culinary delights created by guest chefs and best restaurants in the country. This festival also features live music performances. Let's meet Captain, the 2022 C4A chairperson.
Thank you for joining us. Euphoria is an annual festival that shines a spotlight on culinary excellence and the charm for which Greenville is known. From outdoor concerts along the river to major visiting musicians to local bands playing, the music scene alone is well worth the trip. In fact, we have John Burks, better known as Dizzy Gillespie. He is an American jazz trumpet player, band leader, composer, educator, and singer joining us tonight.
It's an honor to be here with you. I have my favorite song, Blue Boogie, to play for you. And it goes a little something like this. music Latin music style called bebop. Sit back and listen to a little jazz rendition.
Great talent, Channel 3, WCCS News. Now we have the one and only Paul Riddle Planet Festival this year. He's agreed to play one of his favorite pieces, Jessica.
Thank you for the kind introduction. I'm lucky to be a Grammy-winning superstar and best known as a drummer for the Marshall Tucker Band. Today I still play and I'm a teacher at Christ Church Episcopal School in Greenville, South Carolina.
Thank you.
the trees. Speaking of tasty treats, let's check out some grapes from Euphoria.
Step right up and tasting the best food around from Charleston. You gotta love low country cooking, and tonight I have some of the best. I'll be making a crowd favorite shrimp and grits with butter angel biscuits on the side. You can't live in South Carolina without liking this savory dish.
I beg to differ with you, Chef. Not everyone likes seafood, but once you try my crispy fried chicken and fresh collard greens, you'll be floating in heaven.
I beg to differ with you again. My barbecue with a spicy mustard sauce with a side of macaroni and cheese will knock your socks off. So you will need to slick it down with some good old sun sweet tea.
And a person who likes to skip right to dessert, head to my tent where you can sample pecan pie, peach cobbler, and beanie wafers. I'll even give you a refreshing cold glass of lemonade to cool you off.
Bonsoir, Greenville. My name is Daniel Boulou, world-renowned Michelin-starred French chef. I'm thrilled to be at Euphoria bringing you my culinary expertise. Some of my scrumptious delights are praised short trips to traditional French sweets.
Melissa, one of nine mice on Maine. We have just filled our bellies on some delicious Euphoria treats. We are so excited to be able to scamper up and down Main Street. We are created by our CCS friend, Jim Ryan.
Hooray, hooray, hooray. We love to nibble our way through downtown Greenville. The cheese boards from Table 301 are worth scurrying through the crowds that come here on the weekends for celebrations like Artist Fair, Fall for Greenville, and Euphoria, our favorite.
Okay, little mice, let's go. Don't forget to stop and smell the delightful flowers and find a favorite place for a game of hide and squeak!
Joining us at Euphoria 2022.
Hello, I'm Elena. With live coverage from beautiful downtown Greenville, you don't have to go far into the downtown area to experience fun and entertainment. The Greenville Zoo, the Children's Museum, and the Greenville Museum of Art are just a few. Our motto is Yeah at Greenville. We are so lucky to have our distinguished mayor here today.
Hello, fine citizens of Greenville. My name is Knox White. Our city has become a favorite destination for diners and shoppers who want to experience our amazing downtown. We have been ranked as one of the top 10 best downtowns in the country. The award-winning Liberty Bridge at Falls Park and the spectacular downtown scene make Greenville a unique place to visit and live. One of our nationwide arts festivals, Artist Fair, is a highlight each year that draws many tourists to the city.
We now take you to Fluor Field, located in Greenville's West End District. We will meet some talented athletes from around the state.
It's great to be in the upstate to throw out the first pitch. I am Justin Johnson from Columbia, South Carolina. I play on the PGA Tour, where I've achieved two major tournament championships. My most recent being named the 2020 Masters Tournament Champion. Nothing like that green jacket.
Hi, I'm Denny Hamlin. I'm proud to be in the upstate tonight. Many of you may recognize me as I won my first NASCAR Cup Series at the Cookout Southern 500 in Darlington, South Carolina. This raceway is nicknamed the Lady in Black. but the track too tough to tame by many NASCAR fans and drivers. But in 2021, I tamed the 501-mile track.
Thank you, Dry fans, for joining us here at the Poirier Field. We're the only minor league team in the upstate. We're excited to play tribute to Shoeless Joe Jackson.
Good evening. My name is rather confusing at times. I got my nickname from fans early in my career. During one game, I had terrible blisters on my feet, so I decided to take off my cleats and run the bases in socks. I guess the name really stuck. Everybody kept calling me Shoeless. I played for the White Sox later in my career, and we won the World Series. I kept my nickname Shoeless, even though I put my shoes back on after that early game.
Good evening. I'm a middle striker with the Greenville Triumph. We're a professional soccer team based right here in Greenville. The club began playing in 2019. After a two-year search, the committee recently decided on the six-acre site at Malden Bridgeway Station. On June 8, 2021, Greenville Triumph announced that they will be fielding a women's side to compete in the new Women's League. Come out tomorrow night and watch us play against North Carolina Courage at 7 o'clock.
We have so many great athletes in our city. Thanks for joining us at Poirierfield. Tonight's news report will certainly put a twist about learning all about the great state of South Carolina. Now let's head up Main Street to the Peace Center, where Eliza will tell us about tonight's special performers.
Good evening, and welcome to South Carolina's Got Talent. I'm your host, Eliza. What an exciting lineup we have in store for you. We'll see special dances from our state, listen to the sound of the Palmetto State's finest musicians, and even have a chance to tap your own toes. So let's get this show moving. Our first performers tonight hail from Charleston, South Carolina. This amazing group of dancers are here to strut their stuff. So let's welcome the fantastic Flapper Girls to the stage.
Well, the Charleston is a snazzy little dance that became popular in the 1920s. It is named for the harbor city of Charleston, South Carolina. Actually, this dance is created by African-American boys in an orphanage in Charleston. It was created to suit a swing style of jazz music. It includes very special moves and includes knee bobs and fancy out heel kicks.
As danced today, the Charleston contains moves from the 20s and 30s as well as jazz steps.
Back in the day, the Charleston was usually danced by couples, but the most popular style is to dance with a group of girls, flapper style.
The Charleston involves a fast twisting your legs and big arm movements.
Famous dancer Josephina Baker not only dances Charleston, but she also had moves that made it silly and funny, like crossing your eyes.
It's time to dance and add on flavor. That's when we add our own special touch to our steps.
Let us give you a glimpse of how this snazzy little dance works. Hey girls, let's Charleston.
What?
real treat. Thanks for sharing that special dance with us. Our next guest is a Lowcountry native. He is here tonight to sing one of his famous songs. Let's please welcome Lee Bryce to the stage.
Hello, South Carolina. I'm Lee Bryce, American country music singer, writer from the Sumter, South Carolina. It is so great to be back in the Palmetto State.
Songs in the kitchen, playing on the radio, coffee on the counter, bacon frying on the stove, Billy Graham on TV, mom and daddy kissing, songs in the kitchen, songs in the car, fresh pressed Sunday clothes, mama putting on her makeup, Daddy's Bible on the dashboard, me and Lewis in the backseat, singing out our little hearts, songs in the car. Yeah. All my dreams came true, my songs took me far. Now I'm seeing them every night, these bright lights upon this stage.
To hear this great music from our state. Next up is a song and dance that is sure to put a little twist in your soul. So let's welcome the oh-so-talented Twister Girls to the stage.
The twist of the dance was inspired by rock and roll music.
The original recording of the twist topped the Billboard charts twice, once in 1960 and again in 1962. In the early 60s, it became the first worldwide dance craze.
It was originated in the late 50s among teenagers.
Hey girls, did you know that Chubby's real name was Ernest Evans, and he was born in 1941, Spring Gully, South Carolina?
Hey, where's that boy?
Hey there, cool cats. I'm here tonight with my superstar, Slick Looks, and my terrific Twister Girls to entertain you. So let's get this show on the road.
Just like
all this wonderful music. But like they say, all good things must come to an end. So here to end our show tonight is the one and only Bill Pinkney. Bill is an original member of the Drifters. So let's welcome him to the stage.
It's my pleasure this evening to share all my fabulous South Carolina talent with you. Is anybody in the house out there from my hometown, Dalzella, South Carolina? Let's get it on.
When this whole world starts getting me down, and people are just too much for me to face, I climb way up to the top of the stairs, and all my cares just drift right into space.
Joining us live on Channel 3 WCCES News.
And remember, it's always a great day to be a Cavalier.
The third grade has researched our state from the Blue Ridge Mountains to the Atlantic Ocean, from the early years of rice and indigo to the present year 2022. We're lucky to call South Carolina home. We can head to the mountains or take the southern route to the beach. Either way, we can arrive at our destination within the day. What a wonderful place to live.
We've learned about our state and its history. It was once home to the first South Carolinians. It was home for settlers from Europe and Africa. Our state was one of the 13 original colonies. We helped form this great nation, the United States of America.
South Carolina has changed. It has gone through good times and hard times. New people have come here. Some are from other states and some are from other countries. Many people have helped our state grow and change. They have left a valuable heritage. Each of us has different customs, but we learn from each other. We work side by side.
Together, we are all South Carolinians. The state belongs to us. Remember, South Carolina is a place where tea is sweet and accents are even sweeter.
Summer starts in April and ends in November. Front porches are wide and words are long.
Chicken is fried and biscuits come with gravy. Macaroni and cheese is a vegetable.
Pecan pie is a staple.
Y'all is the only proper noun.
Everything is darling and someone's heart is always being blessed.
South Carolina is always here and always home.
Thank you.